Thanks for checking out this movie review. This is for the 2018 Halloween movie, and yes, it is a sequel to the original from 1978 by John Carpenter. Wrote it, directed it, and did music for it. And he and his son, along with one other guy who I can't remember at the moment, also did the score for this updated one, well, this sequel. A lot of their music is very, very similar to the original, but kind of dressed up a little bit, and in a very good way. It's very nice. They have the original music that everyone's very, very familiar with, but they kind of add a little extra to it, and it really works well. I like it quite a bit. So, much like the original, a score is a very, very strong portion of the film. So, this will be spoiler-free. I don't want to say much about anything. I don't believe in doing, like, spoiler reviews. I believe that we can kind of talk about the movie enough that, you know, it can be enjoyed by people who have seen it and people who have not seen it without giving out any spoilers, and that's what we're going to do. Quick thing to point out behind me right here, PJ Souls, who was in the original Halloween. So, interesting, that's an autograph. Anyway, how was this 2018 Halloween? So, if I'm going to give it like a letter rating, if I give it like between A through F, I'm going to give it a solid B, I believe. I think a solid B is a good one. It wasn't anything crazy new or awesome, but it was familiar, it was good. There were some new elements. I know I just said like it wasn't crazy new or awesome, but they had some new elements in sense of the Halloween story, specifically with Laurie Strode. So people going into this isn't really a spoiler, know that it's not so much a movie about Michael Myers, and you're not going to really learn stuff about Michael Myers. It's mainly a story about Laurie Strode. It's about what Michael Myers has done to Laurie Strode and how her life has been. So it basically picks up 40 years after the original movie's events. So you're seeing the impact of what happened in that first movie on Laurie Strode's life and what that ended up meaning. Sorry, shaking because my cat's walking on the table. So that's a really interesting aspect of it. So it's about her, so if you haven't seen it, just know that going into it. So you're not going to get these backstories about Michael Myers that, you know, were in a bunch of the other original sequels. So, and for that reason, I don't know, some people may not like it for that reason because they might want more about Michael Myers, but the thing is, that's been done, and it's been done a lot, so you can kind of see those other movies if that's what you really want. So for this one, I think overall the directing was really nice, the cinematography was great, it looked realistic, it looked like kind of gritty, and there's my cat Chloe, she's making an appearance. It looked gritty, it was pretty violent actually, and it was very like intense violence. The combination of the score while it was going on and how they shot it and how intimate it felt when there was violence happening and the murdering, very effective because it made you feel like there, kind of like caught up in the moment. So that was really nice. Acting was really well executed. Jamie Lee Curtis did a really good job, and I will just say it's just very nice to see her reprise that role, especially if you really like the original Halloween. I don't like love the original Halloween, but I like it, and I really recognize its importance as far as horror film goes, at least. And I really have a lot of respect for John Carpenter. I had met John Carpenter earlier this year, it was like March, at a Monster Mania convention in New Jersey, and I got him to sign up like a poster for the movie The Thing. But he had said at the time, someone was asking him about, oh, how's the new Halloween gonna be, and he was like, oh, trust me, if you like the original Halloween, you're really gonna like it, it's gonna be good. So I heard that and I was like, oh, that's cool. And then, you know, a few minutes later I'm thinking, well, wait a minute, would he really tell people if it wasn't gonna be good? So I went in kind of being like, I don't know, we'll see. But no, I mean, he was right. If you liked the original Halloween, you were going to like the 2018 film, most likely. There are a lot of, it feels the same in a lot of ways, kind of, not that it follows like the exact same formula or anything, but there's a lot of kind of formulaic commonalities from the first one to this. And that's nice for familiarity, but it also just goes well with the story. You know, it helps in telling the story that needs to be told because it's continuous. You know, like, we're just catching back up with Laurie Strode. So it would make sense that a lot of the way the original story was told would be carried over into the way this story is told, because they're all together. So there are some good surprises in it, some pretty good dialogue surprises in it. I don't want to say anything past that because it's a tad bit spoilery. There are references to some of the sequels. There's actually a bit of dialogue, I won't say exactly what it is, but that kind of jabs at the sequels in a sense. And then there's a reference to one of the sequels in particular in the film that I really enjoyed, because I enjoy that sequel. And I mean, it's the one that didn't really have anything to do with Michael Myers. So the fact that that was called out, I thought was really super cool, because most people probably would have thought it would not have been called out for that reason, since it didn't have anything to do with Michael Myers. But it's cool. I really like it. Also, I just, as I'm talking, realized that people make comments like these slatted doors for closets. People make comments all the time about how, like, how many slatted doors can you have in Halloween? And I just think it's funny that I happen to have those right here. That was not intentional. It just happened. But anyway, yeah. Really good film. Like I said, very solid B. I felt like there was more that they could do with the story to, like, push it a little bit further, get a little deeper into backstory. But I don't think they really wanted to do that. I think they just wanted to focus mainly on Laurie and show you the impact that Michael Myers has had on Laurie long-term, not just short-term. Because that is something that really is missing from a lot of horror films, is they'll make sequels, but they don't build off the first one or build off of other ones in the sense that they have those characters who, you know, will change over a long period of time. That doesn't really happen so much. So for that reason, it is kind of fresh to see that take. And it's nice. I mean, because in a sense, it is kind of new. Even though everything still feels very, very familiar. And there's a lot of stuff that you're just like, well, that's not, you know, this is pretty typical. So, but I know a lot of people have said they played it really safe. I think so, in the sense of a lot of stuff they do in the film, but the overall theme and their focus on Laurie Strode and everything like that, I don't think they played it safe with that, because that easily could have thrown people off and they'd just be like, eh. But what I'm hearing from pretty much everyone is that they like it. And sorry, my cat's yelling in the background, so I don't know. She wants to say she loved Halloween too. No. I happened to see it at a drive-in theater, which added another aspect to it. Shout out to Benji's Drive-In in Middle River, Maryland. That's a good way to see a movie like this, at the drive-in. It was awesome. And they had one of their staff walking around dressed as Michael Myers while the movie was going on, so you just kind of see, like, the shadow of a Michael Myers walking by the car, which was really cool. So I did like that. But yeah, overall, solid B. I liked it. Do I think they'll do anything else? No, I don't think so. I will say, if you're watching this and you haven't seen the original 1978 one, you definitely should do that, because I have heard from some people who went and saw the movie who didn't see the original that they were just kind of like, I didn't really. And I'm like, yeah, but there's like a history and it means so much more if you know the beginning of it, like, especially with the way this movie's laid out. So if you're watching this and you have not seen the original and you do want to see the new one, do yourself a favor, track down the original, 1978, do it. You will thank me, because the movie is not going to mean as much. You're not going to care as much unless you see that original. Very important, in my opinion. So, thank you everyone for checking this out. I'm sorry I went a little bit long, rambled a little bit, repeated a few things, but that's, sorry, one of the things I do. Let me know if you want to see me do more of these movie reviews. I'll even take requests, actually, if you want to do that. I'm not opposed to it at all. And it doesn't even have to just be horror. If there's something that you really want my opinion on, I will say I'm pretty good about giving you straight up opinions on movies, and I'm not sugarcoating things. So, yeah. But the other thing you can do, other than make some comments down here and give a thumbs up, is you can hit the subscribe. If you want to know anytime that one of my videos is available, you can also hit the little notification bell, and that will do the trick for you. Like I say all the time, it takes you like a second to just hit that subscribe, and it does nothing to you. It's no inconvenience, but it means a lot for me long term. If I can get enough people then it'll be worth getting monetized and maybe doing some more unboxings, because I do unboxings, doing more movie reviews, maybe doing some Blu-ray reviews. I actually believe I'm going to do one. I have the new Trick or Treat Blu-ray, which I'm going to watch on Halloween, and I'm planning to do a review of that Blu-ray. So if that's another thing that you're interested in, let me know as well in the comments, and I will think about doing even more of that. Also, some rankings. I want to be doing some rankings. I watched all the Nightmare on Elm Street films, and I'm going to do a ranking of those. Also, Friday the 13th, and all of the Masters of Horror episodes, which is 26, so it's a lot. But anyway, once again, thank you. Please hit subscribe, and until next time, keep it brutal.